early to mid-spring is usually the risk period for diamondback moth attack in canola crops. Generally, once crops are sort of in the flowering to sort of mid to late potting, if seasonal conditions have been favourable for diamondback moth, that's when they'll be at play, and a regular sort of weekly monitoring program is essential to be able to preempt a caterpillar population build-up before a significant crop damage can occur. We generally rely on sweep netting, groups of 10 sweeps taken from at least 5 different sites within a crop and averaged to give an average number of caterpillars or grubs per 10 sweeps. Generally, you need the foliage reasonably dry, good, sunny, calm weather is perfect, and then refer to the published threshold levels to make a spray decision. Again, taking note of natural enemy activity in those sweep catches to factor that in. If you have a population that is perhaps still just below threshold, but there's considerable diamondback moth parasitoid activity and associated predator activity, well then that should be factored in. Continue monitoring, perhaps delay the decision to spray, because it's not uncommon for diamondback moth populations to take a downturn as a result of natural enemy levels or as a result of rain events, which often take toll on diamondback moth numbers. If you require further information on diamondback moth monitoring and management, refer to the GRDC website, which has an updated fact sheet on diamondback moth management available.